Study. This month's theme is freedom. Are you free? Free from what? From death? From stress? Alright, later we will know how God made us free. Free from what? Free from our sins. So before we start, we will have an opening prayer to be led by Mr. Rex.
Everyone is sitting on the stage. Okay, please bow down your head, close your eyes, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you today to give you honor, glory, and praises. Forgive us, Lord, for all the mistakes we have done in our life. Thank you for this opportunity we have gathered here for one purpose. To acknowledge that you are our God. Help us realize, Lord, that without you, we are nothing. We can't overcome problems we have in our life. You are the only one who can get rid of the burden we have. Thank you, Lord, for everything. In Jesus' name, amen.
That what they have done has been done in the sight of God. Who am I that the Lord of all the earth?
Yeah.
Who can know my name? Who can feel my hurt? Who am I that the bright and morning star choose to light away my ever wandering heart? Not because of who I am, but because of what you've done. Not because of all I've done, but because of who you are.
Approaches philosophy first, What is philosophy? Philosophy is the study of general and fundamental problems, such as those connected with reality, existence, knowledge, body's reason, mind and language. It can also find its way to religion, ethics, logic, and art. Philosophy says, what can I do for you? Burden says, I have a problem on my back and I can't get rid of it. Can you please take it off? Philosophy answers, ah, no problem. I have all the answers to all life's questions. So philosophy tries to take the burden off her back. Tried hard several times, but can't take it off. Burden tries to beg philosophy to try harder, but philosophy has gotten tired of it and says, go away, there's nothing I can do for you. The Bible says, Colossians 2:8, see it that no one takes you captive by philosophy and empty deceit, according to human tradition, according to the elemental spirits of the world, and not according to Christ. Philosophy is just human wisdom, therefore temporary. And so it will fail. And if it fails, it can't give you real freedom. 1 Corinthians 2:13. And we part this in words not taught by human wisdom, but taught by the Spirit, interpreting spiritual truths to those who are spiritual. Philosophy may give you a temporary escape from pain, hurts, or reality, but it can't give you real freedom.
Next, she turns to money. Burden says, ah, perhaps money can save me. So she approaches money and begs her burden off her back. Money tries to help her, but really can't, so money drives her away. What does the Bible say about money? 1 Timothy 6:10 says, for the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil. Ecclesiastes 5:10 says, he who loves money will not be satisfied with money. Hebrews 13:5 says, keep your life free from the love of money and be content with what you have, for God has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Money itself is not bad, but if you start to fully trust on money, you will be in trouble. Money may give you happiness, but it is only temporary. Money cannot give you real freedom.
She also turns to occult, hoping that it can totally free her from her bondage. What is occult? Occult means supernatural, mystical, or magical beliefs, practices, or phenomena. It includes witchcraft, sorcery, voodoo, and many other involving magic. These are evil. They can never free you from any kind of trouble. Occult will only destroy your soul and your body, and then it will try hard to destroy your family and your loved ones. The Bible says, Leviticus 19:31, do not turn to mediums or necromancers. Do not seek them out. And so make yourselves unclean by them. I am the Lord your God. Revelation 21:8. But as for the cowardly, the faithless, the detestable, as for murderers, the sexually immoral, sorcerers, idolaters, and all liars, their portion will be in the lake that burns with fire and sulfur, which is the second death. Those who practice occult will not go to heaven, but will go to hell.
Then
burden turns to knowledge. Knowledge is useful only if we use it right. If we use it for evil, it can never free us from trouble. Good knowledge must be based on God's standards. So the Bible says in Hosea 4:6, "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge." And in Proverbs 1:7, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. Fools despise wisdom and instruction." So human knowledge which is not based on God's standards is nothing. It will also fail. No matter how intelligent you are, if you don't have God in your life, you will eventually fail. She also turns to vices, but even worse things happen for her. So what do you mean by vices? Vice means immoral or wicked behavior. It involves any kind of addiction, sexual immorality, excessive alcohol drinking, pornography, and many others. So vices can never give you freedom. On the contrary, a vice is a strong bondage that imprisons you, corrupts you, and eventually destroys you. So the sperm girl is now desperate, and she doesn't know what to do. She really wants to be free. So who can save her? No one can ever save me, she sighed, not knowing that Jesus is just there, waiting for her to ask him. Then Burden starts to build up some hope and tells herself, there must be someone out there, or up there. She now starts to open her heart and reaches out to that someone, her hope. And Jesus touches her and comforts her, helps her stand and be strong, and took the burden off her back. You might also be just like this burdened girl. You might also be experiencing the same thing. We are here to tell you that none of these things, not philosophy or any kind of religion, not money, not a cult, not knowledge, not even vices, can ever rescue you. Nothing and no one can ever give you perfect freedom except for God.
The Bible says, 2 Corinthians 3:17, "Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom." John 8:32, "And you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free."
John 14:6, Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." John 17:3, "And this is eternal life, and they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent."
In Galatians 5:1, Christ has set us free. For freedom, Christ has set us free. Stand firm, therefore, and do not submit again to a yoke of slavery.
You can experience real freedom, but only if you have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. Jesus, I believe, is standing at the door of your heart, and He wants to come inside your heart. If you let Jesus be a part of your life, I want you to bow down and close your eyes. We are going to pray together. Freedom is free. You don't need to pay no money. But it is through the heart that Jesus wants to speak to you. Could you bow down your head? We're going to pray together, okay? You can follow after me. Lord Jesus, I want you in my life. Please come into my heart. Please come to my heart. And be my Lord and my Savior. I want the freedom that only you can give. to you. Please take full control.
Please take full control.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. If you want to know about God, you can speak to us anytime. We'll be open for everyone. Thank you so much.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to be, and grace my speech released. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free by God, my Savior, who ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy and grace, unending love, amazing grace.
Welcome, Miss Kate. ka mo?
Okay. Yes.
Ah, Mayuki. My name is Tetsuko Mikame, otherwise known as Kei. I've been studying at CNC Language Academy for almost 3 months, and I love it here. I chose CNC because of peaceful location and great tutors. When I first arrived, I didn't have confidence to speak in English. But since I've made great progress, I'm thankful to everyone at CNC. The tutors are brilliant. Some of them challenged me to try the IELTS course, and I did. They provide a lot of information about practical and useful English in daily life, and give me a chance to use them until I can do it. I really enjoy studying English here. During my stay here, I met a lot of friends through English. They are from Korea, Taiwan, China, Japan, and the Philippines. They inspired and motivated me. I'm going to continue studying English and make good use of it for my future job. I want to contribute something good to the society through using English. Hiroshima City is a truly a fantastic city, and CNC is a great place to study at. Since I took up ESL's course, I have been studying at the library. When I started studying on ESL's course, I always tried to write down new words and review the meanings after class. At the same time, in order to acquire daily conversation skills in English, I learned some practical phrases from dramas and practiced them in actual conversations. Conversation with my friends are also significant opportunities to practice English. I realize I come to use English not only as part of my studies, but also as a communication tool. After changing the course to IELTS, as I have only 1 month left, I don't want to waste my study time. I always study as soon as I finish dinner. Even though I have a lot of homework, I gradually enjoy studying English. Thanks to the instruction from my tutors. Originally, I was not good at reading and writing, and these were my weak points. So, I didn't expect much improvement from my writing and reading skills. My tutors gave me some tips how to organize my writing techniques and to read using scanning and skimming. In my first month, I got the Most Improved Student Award and Best Writer Award. I also didn't expect this, so I was really surprised and couldn't believe it. I was really honored to be chosen as our dean. Moreover, last month, I got the Best in IELTS Award in CNC. I started with 4.5 band score, and after 2 weeks of studying IELTS, my band score went up to 6.0. And also, although I missed the chance to win, I was nominated for Best Speaker Award. My advice is for you, not to give up, even if it's difficult. Keep reaching your goal and be positive. Never give up. Thank you. Good afternoon to all of you.
So when we pray, we start like this. Father God, we thank you for a special day you have sustained this man with us. I know he tried his best in studying CNC, and improving his skills. I pray that he will be able to reach his dreams and all the efforts, Father God. I hope you give him more patience, Father, and perseverance in the coming year, Father God. Whatever her dreams, to be a doctor and feel the medicine, Father, I pray for more blessing. Give him good health, Lord Jesus. Thank you for this special man to be used for your glory and for your honor as you go back or wherever you're going to reach. Father God, be with him and keep him safe in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Celebrating. Rina! Rina is going to go home too. We're going home. Aki, Jesse is going to stay here, going home too. Father, we thank you for these wonderful souls, Father God. We pray for Rina, Jesse, Aki, and Kay. Lord, you're going to be with them, Father. All those words that have been thrown upon them, let it be a seed that will be harvested, Father God. Let it multiply, reach upon their lives, and speak to their hearts, Lord God. I prophesy a brighter future upon their lives, Father God. All these things that have been spoken and have been heard through their hearts, Father God, will be fruitful, Lord God. Let the Spirit move upon them, Father God. I hope and pray that they will know more about you, about Jesus Christ, and what is the special purpose of their lives. I pray that they may reach their dreams, and I pray that their lives will be fulfilling, Lord God. And I hope that you keep them safe, give them good health, and thank you for all the friends that have been supporting them, all the tutors and all the staff of CNC that had been a part of their fruitful life here. Thank you so much, Father. We give you all the glory and honor. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. And for the food, Father God, thank you so much, Lord. Thank you for the nourishment of our body and for the provision and the financial support we are receiving from this activity and all those friends that have come apart, become a part of this activity and all those staff and managers that have been supporting Lord God, bring to them back in double portion of your blessing, Father. Thank you so much for the joy, the love, the peace, the deliverance through the dances and the skills of tutors and students being shared in this activity, Father. In Jesus' name, we give you all the glory, Lord Jesus. Thank you. Amen.